new development here. Now the U.S. Trade Representative on the record, Robert Lighthizer, saying today the president notified the Congress of his intent to sign a trade agreement with Mexico and Canada, if it is willing, 90 days from now. Lighthizer going on to say here, the agreement is the most advanced and high-standard trade agreement in the world. Over the next few weeks, Congress and cleared advisors from civil society and the private sector will be able to examine the agreement. They will find it has huge benefits for our workers, farmers, ranchers, and businesses, saying, we have also been negotiating with Canada throughout this year-long process. This week, those meetings continued at all levels. The talks were constructive, and we made progress. Our officials are continuing to work toward an agreement. The USTR team will meet with Minister Freeland and her colleagues Wednesday of next week. So the U.S. Trade Representative now saying on the record that negotiations with Canada will continue on Wednesday of next week, saying that the president has now officially notified, kicking in that 90-day clock, notified Congress of his intent to sign a trade agreement with Mexico, and they say in a parenthetical here, and Canada, if it is willing, that the president will sign that in 90 days. So where we are right now, negotiations with the Canadians will continue as of Wednesday next week, according to the U.S. Trade Representative, but clearly we're going to reach the end of the day today without a deal in writing, signed and inked by 5 p.m. on Friday, guys.
Eamon, if the deadline originally for Canada was today, given that this is kicked off with 90 days from now, very clearly stated by Ambassador Lighthizer, is the new deadline for Canada 90 days away, or realistically is it going to be next week or soon after or not at all?
There's a nuanced legal answer to that that I can't give you right now, but I think where we're going to land is that this 90-day notification to Congress is trying to finesse that by saying that the United States is going to sign this deal with Mexico in 90 days, and Canada could be a part of it. So this is the official 90-day clock being started here by the administration. I'm going to need some legal guidance here and some congressional guidance as to whether that will pass muster or not. But that seems to be what's happening here, and I'm just reading this in real time for the first time with you guys. So I'm sort of analyzing on the fly here.
I mean, there's a U.S. law that requires the president to give 90 days notice before signing a trade agreement, and he wants to get that done under the current Mexican president and the current Congress, which is why the today deadline is so important on the 90-day clock front.
Right.
The problem is he doesn't have buy-in from Canada.
Right. So the question is, can you notify Congress under the law that you're going to sign a trade agreement and maybe or maybe not have Canada in that agreement? That's sort of what they're saying here, and I just don't know the legal answer to that. We might have some viewers who know who are going to tweet me in a second, but I don't know it as I stand right here.
I think some members of Congress are going to have questions about wanting to know what it all looks like if
does
Canada
this count
hasn't
as
fully
official,
signed on.
Does this count as official 90-day notification or not under the rules? They're saying we're going to do this with Mexico and maybe Canada, and it's going to happen in 90 days.